Hi guys, so wonderful to be with you again. It's me, Wendy Alec. Okay, today I'm gonna share with you, it was just amazing when the Father shared this with me on Joseph. It like blew me completely away. Part of it, okay, which I'll share with you. I have to read this sort of again, I need my glasses. I try without it, but I can't, okay. Oh no, please don't write insane now. Believe for your eyes, all right? Yes, it's fine. these are not real. They're just times two, because I'm getting older. None of us, until we reach heaven, can fully know or understand the seasons Joseph must have gone through. Imagine, and think about it. I had to think about it. Imagine he was promised his gift of dream interpretation would be remembered and mentioned before Pharaoh, but then that promise was forgotten. So he had to continue on in prison with no idea how long he'd stay confined in captivity. It's like for some of you who've been ill for so long. I remember when I was ill for so long, the thing that got me mentally was that I had no idea when it would end or if it would ever end. That's one of the toughest things that you can go through. Very hard for anyone who's never been ill to understand, but for you who need healing, the Father really understands that. And listen, he healed me. He can heal you. Honestly, he can. This was already after he'd been thrown into the pit by his brothers. His multicolored coat was a gift from his father, like you, like the destiny on your life. You have a multicolored coat signifying the incredible and huge destiny on your life. That's your God-ordained mantle. And so many of us find ourselves in similar situations, presently standing or clinging to what sometimes seems like our last breath. We're walking one foot in front of the other each day, wondering, is this the day? Is this the day when all of God's promises and suddenlies will finally manifest? Then waking up in the morning, and this is the really hard thing, and once again, the captivity is still there. So we cry out to God for his infinite grace. We cry out to the Father for more courage and for more strength to face and continue walking through those things in our life. Things in the natural that may threaten to crush our souls, yet we walk one more step and take one more breath. But today, such beloved hearts, I hear the Father saying, I've heard your cries. Oh, beloved struggling one, your cries have reached my altar. And as I look down upon your weary heart, heaven is filled with uproarious joy. Dust off the multicolored mantle I've given you, for even as Joseph's suddenly manifested, your destiny, your journey of such incredible faith and fortitude is ever before me. And your determination and your courage, my son, your courage, my daughter, even in the days of greatest weakness, rises up before my throne as a beautiful fragrance, as it was for Cornelius. And yes, I've heard your cry, how long, God, how long? It seems the prison walls are closing on me, and here is my promise to you today. My promises and suddenlies will manifest, and this is what just blew me away. I believe that it was total rhema and revelation from heaven. Helped me so much. If Joseph had been released from prison when he wanted to be, when they forgot to tell the Pharaoh about his dream interpretation, the time that he asked to be remembered before Pharaoh, he would have been released, but he would either have stayed in prison or he would have been released. But if he had been released at that specific time, he would have been released as an ordinary man and just gone about his business. I'm going to say that again. When he was desperate to be remembered before Pharaoh, if he had been released at that time, he would have just been released as an ordinary man, because the circumstances and all the behind-the-scenes maneuvers that God and the Holy Spirit and Jesus were doing were not complete. And he would have just gone out there, never been the deliverer of Egypt, never been second in line to Pharaoh. He would have just gone out and been an ordinary man. That is for all of us, me included, and all of us who've been crying out and saying, Father, where's the suddenly? Now, if you don't, and crying and saying, I don't understand. If we got our way sometimes, guys, when we so need help and we so want our way, if we got our way, we would be released into our destiny. No, we would be released as an ordinary man. And so there's times and seasons when we don't understand why our suddenlies aren't appearing, especially when the pressure's on, when the pressure is so intense on us. But you need to just understand that God, the Father's working for you behind the scenes. This is a rhema word for some of you today. I absolutely can feel it from the Father. Okay, so the Lord said, let me say, beloved, this is such a profound truth. Joseph would either have stagnated in captivity or been released, not a second in charge to Pharaoh, ruler over Egypt, but released back into life as an ordinary man. And the Father says, but I, the I am, the one who ordained him, who called him, who appointed him unto a great and incredible destiny, had to ensure that he was passed over and seemingly forgotten, or else his destiny would have been aborted. I can feel the anointing. And so he continued day by day, seemingly overlooked, seemingly passed over. Such hope must have risen in his heart and was deferred, left to the day to day, still in captivity, living with unfulfilled destiny in his heart and the passion of my promises burning in his bones. The Father says, your Pharaoh and destiny will intersect. For I had every day of Joseph's life written in his life scroll, and I knew the exact day, the precise hour, the exact moment when his destiny would converge. So I had to ensure that when Joseph cried out to me, your promise, Father, release me, that it was in the holy vortex where Joseph's destiny and his apostolic mantle to deliver Egypt would intersect. And it's exactly the same for you today. There's a holy vortex when your destiny and your mantle and are going to intersect. But we often do not know the timing, but the Father does. Therefore, he seemed forgotten, for I knew there was another day. For I knew there was another day that was marked in heaven. A day marked in destiny when Pharaoh's heart was ready to be moved. And so Joseph came before Pharaoh. And he was appointed a second in command to Pharaoh, the deliverer of Egypt. And the Father says, and so it is with so many of you, beloved. Your suddenly awaits you, your heavenly intersection of timing. I can feel the anointing of the Father. Your Pharaoh and destiny will suddenly intersect, and oh, what rejoicing you will have. Oh, hold on, beloved, says the Father. Hold on, beloved, hold on to me, for your suddenly time of destiny will not evade you. It's on its way. It is coming. It is coming, and all of heaven rejoices, and I will do things in a day that you have waited for years to manifest, and you shall lift up your head and your eyes to me, the great lover of your soul. He said, love your Abba Father. And so if that's you, then you just stand or raise your hands right now. Father, Daddy, I know in my life, oh my gosh, there's so many times when I've been out on my terrace there and I would cry and say, Father, Father, deliver me, please, please. And it was so hard. And then that's when he showed me this. And oh my gosh, Father, so I just thank you, Father. Father, for the holy vortexes, Father, for every son and daughter out there, Father, that are written in their life scroll, Father, in the heavenlies and in that holy vortex, I thank you, Father, for your mandate. The Father says, for your mandate, there's a suddenly coming when your mandate and your destiny is going to come into a holy vortex, when he's prepared the hearts that he needs to prepare for you. And he says to you, beloved, seemingly passed over, brokomba, seemingly forgotten, broko, seemingly way past time, umbrikasa, no, says the Father, ungondogo, ungaga rasta, hungista gatasta da, lift up your weary hands, umbrokosu, strengthen your weary knees, umbroko dogo bakasta gihim bagasana, for I, the Lord God of Israel, I have not forsaken you, I have not forgotten you. See, your name, your light is engraved on the palm of my hands, and your life scroll is ever before me. Umbroko, it sits on my desk in my library. Umbroko sibaga, and you shall see that day. You shall see that day. Your suddenly, and it's going to be your suddenly, even as Joseph before you, and Daniel, and King David, as they all saw their suddenlies manifest, you shall see my suddenly come to pass in your life. And I just want to say as well, you know, when King David, you know, when he was anointed, wow, you know, and he slew Goliath, wow, it got even better. And then he went into Adullam, okay, and then it got even worse when he went to Ziklag, okay. And did you know that he was with the Philistines? He lived, actually lived with Achish of the Philistines. This is the king, okay. And he was in fear. And when you read some of his psalms, oh, Father, woe is me. I'm falling in a deep pit or whatever. Believe me, he, you know, God's seen it. He understood. And yet David came into that holy vortex of time as well, when his destiny and his holy apostolic mandate to be king of Israel came into line, and he became king of Israel. The Father has not forgotten you. He loves you so much, okay? Loves you, loves you. Father, we thank you for your glory. We thank you for your presence. Thank you, Father. We're walking the walk of champions. Father, we're walking the walk of champions. Father, you said we would fellowship, and this isn't light. We get religious over this. We fellowship, we partake in the sufferings of Christ, okay? We all know, yes, we have victory because Jesus took everything on the cross. But it doesn't mean that the disciples weren't persecuted. It doesn't mean that some of their heads weren't cut off. It doesn't mean that they weren't martyred. I'm not saying that for us, okay? It's fine. It hasn't come to that time yet. We're not in that dispensation. But what I'm saying is we are in a war. Onward, Christian soldiers, marching as to war with the cross of Jesus going on before. When you look at Private Ryan and Dunkirk, they had to fight. We have to be good soldiers and run the race. And so many of you have. You have such a history with God. You have such a history with Jesus and the Holy Spirit and the Father, and he loves you so much. And he just wants to say to you today, your suddenly is coming. Your suddenly is coming. Everything is that you've stored up in the spirit realm is a harvest waiting. And when he releases that harvest, everything's going to intersect. Everything's going to intersect. And in a moment, as with Joseph, in a day, as with Joseph, in one suddenly, as with Joseph, your destiny will come. Thank you, Father. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for the anointing that breaks the yoke, Father. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for your anointing. Thank you for your suddenly. Thank you for your encouragement. Thank you for the comfort of your Holy Spirit for everyone. Father, watching this. Father, your anointing through the television screen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Love you so much. Your suddenly's coming, guys. Don't give up. Don't give up hope. The Father says, don't you dare give up. Don't give up. Love you so much. From my heart to yours. Love you.